Hi guys, I'm Begonia from Simply Health. A shout out to all those repeating a visit and a warm welcome to all. Today I'm debunking a myth of a food product that I'm sure most of you have heard of, gluten. With so much misinformation buzzing around, it's hard to separate myth from reality, especially when it comes to food and health products. In this video, we will focus on what the gluten fad is all about. If you'd like videos with nutrition, health, and fitness content, please click the subscribe button. You may have been enticed to purchase a food just because it was labeled gluten-free. Even go as far as paying the extra cash for gluten-free products because you thought they were better for your well-being. So let's clarify all this information and find out the truth about gluten. What is gluten? Gluten is an umbrella term that refers to a family of proteins known as prolamins. It is found in certain grains, such as wheat, rye, and barley. Who should avoid gluten? If you have been diagnosed with celiac disease, a gluten allergy, or non-celiac gluten sensitivity, you cannot digest gluten and you should avoid it. Around 1% of the US population have celiac disease. For gluten allergy is about 0.5% of the population. In people with non-celiac gluten sensitivity who undergo testing, the diagnosis is confirmed for about 16 to 30% of them. If you suspect that you may have celiac disease, a gluten allergy or sensitivity, it's best to see a doctor before going gluten-free. Try not to self-diagnose. Once you start removing gluten from your diet, it becomes very difficult to establish if you have any of these illnesses, and it's much harder to be conclusive about a diagnosis and an effective treatment because the blood testing done as a first step to diagnosing these conditions is not meaningful unless gluten has been consumed for a while. So removing gluten before being tested defeats the purpose, and you may never be properly diagnosed nor treated. Which foods contain gluten? Wheat is commonly found in breads, baked goods, soups, pasta, cereals, sauces, salad dressings, and pizza doughs. Barley is commonly found in malt, malted barley flour, malt syrup, malt vinegar, food coloring, soups, beer, and brewer's yeast. Rye is commonly found in rye bread, such as pumpernickel, rye beer, and cereals. A note about oats. While oats are naturally gluten-free, they are often contaminated with gluten-containing grains, as they may be processed in the same facilities. This is quite common. So if you cannot consume gluten, be sure to use oats that are labeled as gluten-free or certified gluten-free. What scientific evidence is there for avoiding gluten for the general population? Gluten is not unhealthy. Millions of people are giving up gluten in hopes of losing weight, improving mood, treating autism, and getting healthier overall. There is currently no scientific evidence showing that a gluten-free diet is effective for weight loss, beneficial to your health, or provides you with more energy if you have not been diagnosed with celiac disease or a gluten allergy or sensitivity. What may be the consequences of avoiding gluten in your diet? There are significant drawbacks to following a gluten-free diet. For example, gluten-free processed grain products are lower in fiber, iron, zinc, B vitamins, and potassium. A gluten-free diet may increase the risk of deficiencies, especially in B vitamins, iron, calcium, and trace minerals. Gluten-free foods often are higher in fat and sugars than their gluten-containing counterparts. A study by the British Medical Journal of over 100,000 participants without celiac disease found that those who restricted gluten experience a higher risk of heart disease than those who didn't. Gluten-free diets may starve the good bacteria in our intestines. Lowering the amount of this bacteria is associated with gastrointestinal diseases like irritable bowel syndrome, colon, and colorectal cancers. Lastly, gluten-free products are between 200 and 250% more expensive than their counterparts. For the vast majority of people who do not have celiac disease or a gluten allergy or sensitivity, there is no need to restrict gluten in your diet. A healthy dietary pattern includes higher amounts of whole grains and lower amounts of refined grains and added sugars, which is much harder to find in a gluten-free diet. Thank you for spending this time with me. I hope this information helped you become more aware about gluten. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more weekly info. Until next time, cheers to your health.